Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Viscera Cleanup Detail. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot my overlay. There we go, that's much better. Alright, are you guys ready for... Okay, no, that's not my overlay either. This is my overlay. Pah! I say that to... Pah! Overlay what? There's nothing to overlay. Hello, everybody, welcome back to Viscera Cleanup Detail. We still have some mopping to do, so mop talk is still on the agenda. But I also think that You guys asked some of you guys asked questions about my plans for doing a trash burn, and I think I should like to try to take this video as an opportunity to try to address some of those concerns and perform the aforementioned burn and do the splits at the same time. We got a lot of baggies here, and I'm spreading more guts, but I looked at it, and I think that actually doing the pre-mop that we did is going to save us a lot of time. We're only about an hour into this already, and I had to look at the name of the facility again when I loaded the save file. So thank you guys for teaching me how to pronounce it in the comments. Apparently, this place is actually called... Kadookie Duke. Bye-bye. I'm not sure how to pronounce it still, but thank you for trying. Your efforts are partially wasted on me. Partially because I don't care, and partially because it's a little bit out of my comfort zone. I need to get more of these baskets. So yeah, we were in the process of cleaning up all the biologicals, and after that we do have information left over in the form of bullet holes and casings. But I think I'm going to try to deal with the bullet holes in the casings at the same time as we do the trashing. And I think that we're going to be using Le Broom to do it. So this could be a terrible idea. But in order to do that, I've got to get all the biological boxes and bags full of... or overflowing with various dismembered body parts. Otherwise, I'll be wasting my time. Making a mess to clean a mess... I'm starting to lose my regard for that cleaning strategy. It seemed like a good idea in the beginning, but probably just extra work. And leaving stuff around like this, people complain about me doing it. I don't know, I think it's okay because you can still do a sort of structured clean at some point with them later, as long as you don't derp into them too hard. Like, oh, I don't know, someone, not naming any names, that rhyme with Jeff and only have one F in them, and are actually Jeff. Excuse me? It's supposed to be slosh-o-matic, not splat-o-matic. Oh, that one's not even dirty. I can't even use it. I said I wasn't going to be cleaning any of the walls until I had all of the goopy bits up, and I still think that that's a legitimate strat. It'll help me find the bullet casings later, and also... give me more time for mop talk, where I can focus on things like mopping instead of trying to extract severed body parts glued to a table. It's all green and goopy. This one's gone bad. Check the expiration date on this severed thigh for me, will you? I think we might need to... I think we might need to throw it out. No, I feel fresh! Put me back for sale! Oh, there's a lot of tiny little pieces there. Things you don't want to hear someone say during a corpse inspection and or extraction. Look at all the pieces! How did they get there? See, that's my problem. I could never be a coroner or deal with dead bodies because what I would eventually end up doing is probably trying to put them back together. Because that was how I always dealt with electronics and stuff. I'd take apart something and then try to put it back together. why would that be any different as a coroner? I mean, I'm sure that the families would appreciate the effort. There's been some really good motivational stories about past attempts by great coroners, such as Frankenstein, etc. So, you know, I'm saying there's a precedent. There's a precedent. I wouldn't be that weird. Alright, so bodies are coming up. Those assholes down there happened to die really fucking far from the incinerator, and I think it might be worth it for me to try another glue job. Which, by the way, if a working lady offers you a glue job, turn it down. Trust me, from experience, let me just save you some... I was going to say heartache, but in this case, I'm going to accurately say knob ache. I haven't had to use those two words together in some time now. Alright. It's starting to look a little bit better from the blood front. I was going to say the blood department, but only Peter works there. And he does his magic with water anyway. The name's more of a joke. Wow. The East German judges give you a... I wasn't even trying! I've been falsely accused of attempting to wrangle a bucket from the slosh-o-matic. And it assaulted me. I'm completely innocent of all charges leveled against me of attempting to fabricate a bucket without authorization from the supreme demon lord of severed body parts. I submitted my request in triplicate. That's the only way demons accept requests. Trust me, I've tried a few times. You get duplicate and they get all uppity. Oh, you didn't have time for a threeplicate? Well, you must not really want all that money then, huh, buddy? Oh, if only it were that simple, or divinely complicated. Either way. Right. I'm gonna try to use... Because this is one of those things, like, all these pieces here, each one of them essentially requires a click. Which, by the way, I'm suffering from a work-related injury right now. Oh! Oh! My finger! Oh, I need a break! Alright, break time! Let me print out a... pizza cutter? Space pizza cutter. I've been told that these are wireless, electrically charged, automatic pizza slicing machines. Alright, break time. Oh no! I've further injured my work injury! Quick, someone make a form for me to fill out. I did manage to actually slice my pointer finger on my left hand, also known as my moppin' finger, if you ask me. And unfortunately, I sliced it open, and so I'm playing with a bandage. If my clicks are extra miss today, that may be why I had to get around. And that's one of the reasons that my uploads have been so slow recently. I had to go do a bunch of home maintenance, and I end up always making a blood sacrifice. Speaking of which... Damn it, it never works. It never works like it's supposed to. I remember distinctly saying at the beginning of this video, don't make a mess to clean a mess. Oh well, if you came here for consistency and conciseness, you are disappointed, but at least you're here. Even this guy can offer me some support. I'm just trying to give you a hand, buddy. Just stay in your basket. Man, that is a real mess. I have really done it this time. It was absolutely bloodless and messless down here before I decided to try to save a little time. But you know what? I guess in the name of learning, we've learned that whatever the hell those green canisters are supposed to do, they don't do it at all. Not even close. All they do is make messes. But kind of amazing looking messes, bright green messes. My dad always said, and I'm sure that this is a quote from someone else, but for me this is a quote from Paul. If you're gonna fuck up, do it spectacularly. You know? Don't just fall over. Leave a smoking crater. Go ham. If you get the opportunity, take it. You know, little things like that. Important life stuff. So yeah, I have had a busy week. I had my nieces and nephews over for a while, and I've had to do a bunch of medium annoying home repairs, crawling around under the house, and I recently got into a Twitter argument with someone about whether or not spiders are our friends. And you know what? I'm sick of Spider Bro. I'm sick of hearing about Spider Bro. Because Spider Bro cannot explain to me why all of his bros are capable of poisoning large mammals. Because if Spider Bro is a bro for cleaning up all the insects and getting rid of them for us. Then why are all the spider bros anti-bro bros? You know what I'm saying? Basically, I'm kind of an expert on bro. This confused and amused the hell out of me when I came back to YouTube recently. All of my YouTube videos have the same tags. It just says 1F Jeff, comma, bro. I didn't know why it said that. At first I thought it was like YouTube just assuming that I was kind of a bro, and so I was like, aw, thanks YouTube. You're kind of a bro too sometimes when you're not giving my fucking videos away to ridiculous fucking made-up companies, lawsuit factories, because you're an irresponsible corporate monolith with absolutely no regard for any kind of personal interests of anyone other than your goddamn circus of a board member council. Anyway, I was talking about really positive things like doing home repairs and cleaning and injuring yourself and crawling around underneath my house with a bunch of potentially poisonous deadly spiders. I don't know. I mean, I get it. Not all spiders are... Mother of God! I knew I brought buckets down here for a reason. I was like, in my head, I was like, I need to get a basket, but I got a bucket. Why? I knew I was planning ahead. It's a mess down here, and there will be blood. So yeah, no, I guess I just never got to grow up around the homeboy spiders, like the daddy longlegs and stuff. Because, you know, where I lived in Northern California when I was growing up, it was all black widows. And then when I moved to Oregon, it was all brown recluses. Which, by the way, okay, first, spiders, racist. A little bit. Second, those things are fucking scary. And then when I moved to Arizona, which, there were about a billion reasons that that was a bad idea. Mostly because Arizona is the armpit of the universe. It's basically Baghdad, but with more terrorists. I loved it there, if you can tell. Anyway, it was fantastic. Oh boy. What was that? Spiders. They had these fucking spiders there that I thought were a prank. You know, I thought they were, it's just a prank, bro. It's like some a campfire horror story. Motherfucker. Whoa! Everything's falling to shit. A campfire horror story. They're called wind scorpions is what they're called. I don't know, they've got some sort of Latin bullshit name, I guess, as all animals do. In one way or another. But they're like... They're spiders, but they're shaped like scorpions for evolutionary reasons. They want people and things to think that they are scorpions. So they look like a fucking scorpion. But they're really friggin' fast, like super fast, like NASCAR fast. And they are desert spiders, so they try to hide in shadows. So they fucking chase you to try to get in your shadow. They're not trying to eat you, they don't eat people, but in my mind, if there's a spider running after me, it doesn't matter if it wants to eat me or not. if it's choosing me for any reason at all, I don't want to know it. So yeah, I'm sorry if you're a spider bro believer, but my problem was that I grew up with all of the non-spider bros, all the non-broed out spiders. The spider slayers. So, you can keep your spiders, thank you very much. I think there are much more reasonable ways to deal with insect infestations. For example, napalm and or bug spray. What could be worse than if you were inventing a solution to the problem of too many insects in the world? Would the solution really be a tiny, stealthy, malevolent, evil insect that is not only already an insect, but yes, it can kill insects, but also it can kill people too? I'm pretty sure that almost any R&D group in the world could come up with something better than that. We need it, only more evil and the ability to kill things way above its pay grade. I think we're running out of body parts, and I always get sad when I say that, but I'm excited because that means we get to do more mopping soon. I really do like the mopping, even if my mopping finger is a little off. I'm really happy over how well people have been enjoying the Silent Hunter series. And you know, I don't mean like views and likes and stuff, I just mean the comments that people have been leaving. That's one of those series with the buffering and the series lengths that I understand and expect people to try to take piecemeal and maybe wait for a whole series to come out and like that, stuff like that. So that's perfect. And also at the same time, I can kind of deal with the "Are you dead, Jeff?" thing by uploading videos more frequently. I hope that people are adjusting to life in YouTube as a third world country. I know it doesn't seem that way from your, the citizen, the viewer's perspective, but that's how it is from a content provider's perspective. It's definitely way worse than the Wild Wild West. The gold rush is over and there's only Pinkertons left, and they're coming for what's yours. And ain't nobody gonna stop them. They're too busy getting theirs. Whatever, I don't want to make this another cry festival. I'm not upset. I don't want to get mad. I want to get even. And by even, I mean make videos that are so stupid and weird that they probably shouldn't be advertised upon anyway. I liked that they're changing the system. This is a little funny, actually. They're changing it so that when a third-party company, i.e. a made-up entity designed entirely to steal ad revenue from hardworking content providers that had nothing to do with the original content in question, when those companies claim a video, whether you win or lose the claim, the video's gonna be removed from earnings for the duration of the claim, which, by the way, is at least a month every single time, and for me, you're talking about hundreds per month. Maybe not hundreds per month, more like hundreds per year. A little dramatic there, buddy. I do get a lot of them, though. I still do, and they've recently started acquiring assets to newer series and newer games, and it's always the same made-up companies, so it really is terrible. Some people have been speaking out about it. I don't really want to become an advocate of one thing or another. I'm not going to try to make a soul platform video or something like that. Just casually whine about it every day for the rest of my life like a grown-up, huh? Somebody got a work injury, too. Yeah, that's exactly what it looked like. I stuck my hand in a spider hole. Don't stick anything in a spider hole. Although Rant was a highly underrated book by a highly overrated author who also wrote some other really highly underrated books that were better than the highly overrated ones that he wrote, making up for kind of essentially a normally rated author with normally rated books on the aggregate. Anyway, we got all of our giblets in baskets and all the dirt. See, this is why my commentary is needed. You wouldn't know that I was... If this was just a silent... I was about to say Silent Phil. Silent Hill. Silent Phil! That is the Fresh Prince reboot that we... It is not the one that we need, but it's the one that we deserve! Silent Phil. The uncle is back. And if you won't listen to his sagely advice this time, he'll make you... Where is he? And also, can I borrow $5? Because you're kind of famous now, Mr. Smith. Oh, I heard Uncle Phil died, actually. That makes me sad now. I don't want to be sad. I want to be happy. Well, Uncle Phil probably would appreciate someone working hard, doing their business, and getting the job done. You know, that's kind of sagely uncle advice that I like to hand out to the youngins. So, this one's for you, Unc. I know wherever he is, he's just chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school when a couple of the guys, they were up to no good, started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle into the incinerator." Yo, this is exactly what it's like to be a real janitor. I've never been a real janitor, but I've seen some of them. I've worked late sometimes, and I've worked a lot in retail, and the janitors in retail, no fucks. They ran out of fucks. Like, I think it's actually something that they have to contractually give up when they become a janitor. Sanitation professional. Are you allowed to have any fucks, sir? No, sir. As per union regulations, all fucks are to be submitted upon entry into the sanitorial... proceeding. I think that's pretty much that way with everybody in retail, though. You have to have that me versus the universe mentality if you're working in retail. Otherwise, it just doesn't work. Plus, it teaches you a lot about dealing with people that you don't like. Like how to smile at someone when you're actually snarling. That was a great one that I learned in retail. Hello, may I help you? I don't know, I mean, in the end, they're just people like you. Just trying to make it from one place to another. We're all the protagonists of our own story, I suppose. Although, some of us are the protagonists of some really weird stories, man. What the hell story was Hunter Thompson the protagonist of? I know he was a protagonist, I just don't know what the story was. I've mastered my bucket fear. I no longer fear the Mobius. I embrace it. For if it is time for me to receive a visit from the dread Lord Mobius himself, who am I to either attempt to dissuade him and avoid it, or, furthermore, who am I to run in fear at his dark presence? I have heard more tales of the Mobius basket, but I can't even get them to interact with one another at all. There's no practical reason to stack them on top of each other, so I don't see the formation of a Mobius bucket as something that's either likely to happen or really possible in a relevant way. Plus, it might be something that only happens on multiplayer servers. Okay, so I'm gonna start hucking all the trash up here down there, and I know that this is gonna be one of those things where I'm gonna be previewing what's gonna happen in the next video, hopefully. A lot of this stuff, not trash. Probably can leave it behind. This one's definitely not trash. Oh my gosh. Whoa. I've installed you straight through the universe. This fucking table, man. I do think that the broom is gonna work. It's actually an incredibly useful tool. And when used correctly, I know. Already warning signs. Aside from the fact that I've graduated very swiftly from the cleaning things up to the throwing things down the stairs school of sanitation insight, but the broom is way good, and I think that it will in the long run give us a good way to deal with all of this trash. And the thing is that if we're gonna do the burns, yes, it's gonna leave burn marks no matter what, but if we are gonna do them, we're going to want to do them in the same place. So, a lot of this stuff had to do with how many clicks are involved in the process of picking something up and then moving it to somewhere else and then setting it back down and then lighting it on fire. And listen, if you ask an arsonist, none of those things matter. Except for the last one. But, for seriouslys, can I please have this? There's a garbage down there. No, this is not okay. Hey, I bet this works, though. As long as I hit the floor, that thing's gonna be moving, see? Super janitor. I got psychic powers. So I'm not gonna put any of this stuff in the trash right now. I'm gonna use this to transport some of these little medical doodads just to kind of get them out of the way. They are gonna need to be in their individual stacking areas, and there were a couple of them from what I saw. This is med waste, so this would go here. This is crates. Actually, no, this would go here, because this is... Right, med waste would be the toxic stuff, and crates in green would be medical crates. Got it. Check. Ready to go. This stuff, probably toxic. This guy, Britney Spears, wrote a song called Toxic. Therefore, you gotta go in the fire. It's one of those things. You just... One way or another, everything ends up in the fire. And that's a lot of what today's mop talk has been about. Not so much mopping, much more burning and moving. But if I hadn't done the pre-mop mop, you know, the pre-mop mop? You've never heard of the pre-fight donut? If I hadn't previously mopped these floors, every single one of these baskets, every one of these moves, every step I take, every time I sing a song, it puts up a more likely flag of getting a copyright content ID match. Although, there is something to be said about that. That was, I believe, Mr. Sterling's strategy to dealing with the problem was splicing in clips of unrelated IPs so that multiple companies would have to fight over the same revenue from the same video. But he is doing things a little differently. He doesn't... And this is some... I'm bringing this up not to try to shill for the guy or to try to hate on him. Some of the stuff he says I agree with, some of the stuff he says I don't. So, and I'm sure that the feeling would be mutual. But his situation is different, and I bring this up because it may be my situation. His situation is that he runs a more serious Patreon campaign, and he doesn't run advertisements on his videos. So that works in that case because it's strictly... He's not one of the party members fighting for that ad revenue. And in my case, I am. Which is, it's a little silly because it's peanuts anyway. It's just my own quirk saying that some asshole is going to be making money off of this. Why shouldn't I get a piece of it? That's always been my attitude. That was my reasoning for getting a partnership in the very first place. But all the same, that may be something I have to consider because it's true. The brunt of my revenue is not coming from YouTube, and every single day, it looks more and more likely that not only will it never, but it won't ever even be close. They really are pushing for just the big guys here. It's not YouTube anymore, unless you happen to be an individual with connections to a talent management company which provides you with resources like employees and studio equipment, etc. You know, the average person. YouTube for you, the studio manager. Wow, I told myself I wasn't gonna talk shit, and look at this. I tell one story about hurting my finger, and then bam, it's me against the world again. You know what, that's my problem. I'm a fucking white knight. I'm not afraid to admit it. I know it sucks. What are you gonna do? I will defend your rights, whatever you are. Especially if you happen to be me. In that case, I'll defend your rights to the... Probably not to the death, actually. Mostly just out of personal safety issues and or laziness. Someone said this says... The storm... is... coming. RS. Runestorm, that's the company that made this game. The storm is coming. This is self-referential advertisement, and I will thusly destroy it. Actually, it's not. It's just a cool little Easter egg, and I support those sorts of things. Although, I think it would be funnier if it said something like, I really have to go to the bathroom now, and it was in yellow, or brown, or yellow and brown and red all at the same time. Look at all this trash, yo. See what I'm saying? There's gonna be a bunch of stuff in here. All over this place, that's going to be a problem for us. But you know what? I think we've done a pretty good job for this video. We've removed... we got ahead of the problem of body parts. But there are still some of them. A foot! Oh, jeez. Oh. Woof. Woof. That one had legs and a tail. Alright, guys. This has been... the Sanitation General himself, J. Rizzle Mops a Lot, reporting for duty live from the battlefield, taking part in the struggle, as always, and I will see you next time for more Mop Talk with me, one of me.